Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi taala wabarakatuh. Okay, welcome back to our class Power Systems. Okay, BEJ 20603. Okay, we continue our discussion on chapter 3, okay, balanced three phase system. Okay, so actually we already discuss about introduction. We already discuss about introduction 3.1 and 3.2 three phase source connection. We already discuss about three phase source connection. We have a star and then we have our delta connection configuration. Okay, so today, okay, we discuss what is the relationship between voltages and currents in a three phase circuit. Okay, what is the relationship between voltage and current in both star and delta three phase circuit. Okay, so we continue our discussion on 3.3. Okay, in this chapter basically we focus on balanced three phase sources. Okay, first we discuss about the three phase sources. Basically we focus on balance. Okay, basically in balanced three phase sources, okay, basically we have two connection. Okay, as we know that we have a star or Y connection or we have a delta connection system. Okay, basically in balanced three phase sources, either in Y or delta connection, balanced three phase sources are equal in magnitude. Okay, that's the main definition. What is the balanced three phase sources? Means they are equal in magnitude and frequency and out of phase with each other by 120 degree. Okay, this is the definition of the balanced three phase. Okay, so we can say that the summation of the voltage, for example VRN, the phase voltage, plus VYN plus VBN equal to zero. Okay, the summation of the phase voltage must be equal to zero. Okay, number two, the second condition actually is the magnitude of the phase voltage or line voltage, in this case line voltage, phase voltage, for example VRN, magnitude. Okay, modulus means magnitude. VRN equal to VYN equal to VBN. Okay, this is the definition of the balanced three phase voltage. Okay, number one, number two, and number three. Okay, they have a same frequency. Even in the phase R, Y or B, they have a same frequency. Okay, same frequency. For example, 50 hertz, 60 hertz. Okay, but they are out of phase with each other by 120 degrees. For example, VRN, okay, the phase difference between VRN and VYN equal to 120 degrees. That's the meaning of this statement. Okay, so next we look at to the balance load. What is the meaning of balance load? This one of the balanced source. This is the meaning or definition of the balanced three phase sources. Next, what is the meaning of the balance load? Okay, balance load is one in which the phase impedances are equal in magnitude and in phase. Okay, which mean that the impedance, okay, in the phase one, in the phase two and phase three, or phase R, phase Y and phase B, basically are equal in magnitude. Okay, equal in magnitude and phase. They are same. Okay, which mean that Z1 equal to Z2 equal to Z3. Okay, if we have this condition, we call it our load actually in balance condition. Okay, so next. Okay, this is the definition of the balanced three phase system. Basically, what is the meaning of the three phase system? Previously we discussed about balanced three phase source and balanced load. Okay, So next we will discuss about what is balanced three phase system. Balanced three phase system. Okay, the line and phase current and voltages in all phases are equal in magnitude and separated by 120 degree. Okay, and this is for current. This is for currents and voltages. Equal in magnitude, they are equal in magnitude and separated by 120, and the impedances in all three phases are identical or same each other. Okay, this is the example of the three phase system. We have a source or generator, and this is the load. Okay, so the source or generator are connected to the load. Let's say we have phase R connected to the Z1. Okay, phase Y connected to the Z3, for example. Okay, and phase B connected to the Z2. Okay, this system we can call balanced three-phase system if our magnitude and frequency are same between each phases. Okay, number two, they are separated by 120 degree phase. Okay, that one at the side of the source. At the load side, our Z1, Z2, and Z3 are equal to each other, equal in magnitude and phase. Okay, for example, in this case, the magnitude of the Z1 equal to Z, and the angle equal to theta. Okay. Okay, for example, for the sources, we have VRN equal to V phase angle 0. VYN, we have a V phase angle minus 120 degree. Okay, we have the same magnitude, and we have a different angle between phases equal to 120 degree. Similarly to VRN. Okay, so what is the meaning of unbalanced system? Okay, this is the condition for balanced system. Okay, the summation of VRN plus VYN plus VBN equal to 0. So the magnitude is same to each other. Okay, Z1 impedance, Z1 equal to Z2 equal to Z3. This is the condition for balanced three-phase system. Balanced three-phase system. So next, what is the meaning of unbalanced system? Okay, unbalanced mean one in the which any of the foregoing requirements are not met. For example, let's say we have VRN equal to 10 angle 0, VYN equal to 15 angle minus 120. The magnitude of the voltage is not same, so we call it unbalanced system. Okay, even we can say our system is unbalanced. Let's say we have a Z1 is not equal to Z2, for example, and not equal to Z3. So this condition we call it unbalanced system. So in this course we discuss about balanced three phase system. Okay, we discuss about balanced three phase system. Okay. Solving problem in balanced systems is simple because symmetry allow per phase analysis. That's why in the first step, first we need to discuss about the balanced three phase system lah, because balanced three phase system basically is simple in term of analysis because we can analyze based on per phase analysis, so make it easy lah for us to do the analysis. Okay, so we review Y connected balanced three phase system. Okay, we have a Y connected balanced three phase system, and then we have a star, we have a delta connected balanced three phase system. This is the example of the three phase source lah. Okay, Y connected balanced three phase source. This is Y connected balanced three phase. This is the delta connected balanced three phase source. Okay, Okay, before we discuss in detail about the currents and voltage, how to do the analysis of the system, first of all, we need to understand the notation and conversion for the three-phase circuit. Okay, notation and conversion for the three-phase circuit. Okay, for example, we have a generator, we have a source, okay, or generator, and this is our load. Okay, this is our load. Let's say we have a Y connected source and Y connected load. Okay, so we connected our system, our load and source, okay, by using the transmission line. For example, of course we have a impedance in the transmission line. Okay, for example, we connected our R phase to the load, okay, for the phase R. Okay, the most important thing that you have to understand, that you have to remember actually, is the notation. Okay, the at the source we write the notation in small letter. Okay, for example, phase red we write R. Okay, at the load we write capital R. Similarly to the current, okay, at the load side we write I capital R. Okay, at the source side we write I R. Okay, similarly to phase Y and phase B. Okay, the for example, the voltage across phase R at the generator side we call it VRN. Okay, small rn. The voltage across at the phase R at the load we write VRN. Okay, V capital R and capital N. What is the meaning? The voltage difference between R terminal and neutral point of the load. Okay, similarly to VYN, okay, across Y phase, across ZL, for example, VYN, what is the meaning of VYN? It means that the voltage difference between point terminal Y to the neutral terminal of the load. Okay, V small Y and small N, what is the meaning? Okay, this means the voltage difference between terminal Y and N of the generator. Okay, this notation that you need to remember lah, to differentiate between source and the load notation. Okay. Okay, this is labeling conversion for the voltages and current. The relationship between the line quantities and phase quantities for a given generator or load depends on the type of connection used for the generator and load. Okay, thus in this conversion, VRN, for example, in this case we have a VRN, for example, VRN, the potential difference between R and N at the source side, okay, at the source, okay, represent the phase between line and neutral. Okay, represent the phase voltage between R and N. And while VRY, okay, VRY, for example, this one VRY represent the voltage between lines R and Y. Okay, the voltage difference between line R and Y. This one we call it a line voltage. Okay, VRN we call it a phase voltage. Okay, VRN we call it a phase voltage. VBN also we call it a phase voltage between phase B, between terminal B and neutral point. VYN we call it a phase voltage, okay, between terminal Y and N. Okay. Okay, line voltage, for example, we have a VRY, the potential between two lines, Okay, R and Y. VBR. Okay, the potential difference between line B and R. Similarly to VYB, the potential difference between line Y and B. Okay, that's the line voltages and phase voltages that you have to understand in three phase system. That one for voltages. Okay, how about current? Okay, for the current, okay, for the Y connected system, this is a Y or star connected system, we have a phase current. This one is phase current. Okay, phase current. Okay, and then we have a line current. But in this case, we have a line current IR, IY, and IB. Okay, for the Y connected source, okay, for example, at the phase R, phase current equal to line current. Okay, from the circuit, you can see that from the circuit, phase current, let's say this is the phase current, okay, from the source, equal to line current at the transmission line, equal to the line current. So we can conclude that for the Y connected source, phase current actually equal to line current. Okay, so we write the notation for the line or phase current equal to IR, IY, and IB for each phase. Okay, first we look at to the star or Y connected source. Okay, this is the typical connection of the star connected generator supplying power to a three phase load. Okay, we have a red and yellow line and blue line connected to the three phase load. Okay, this is the notation that we need to understand. This is the phase voltage, this is the line voltage, line voltage, line voltage, and then this is the line current. In Y connected source or star connected source, line current equal to phase current for all phases. Okay, let's say we assume our system in our source basically connected in RYB sequence. Okay, do you still remember what is the meaning of RYB sequence? Okay, R is our reference followed by Y phase and then followed by B phase. Okay, and taking phase voltage VRN as a reference, then we have the following phasor expression. Okay, phase voltage, let's say we have VRN as a reference, V angle 0, VRN as a reference, of course reference means our phase angle equal to 0. Okay, RYB, so VYN, VYN equal to V angle minus 120 degree. Okay, 120 degree. Okay, different. Okay, minus because Y follow R. Okay, VYN, and then VBN equal to V angle 120 degree, or we can write V angle minus 240 degree. Okay, this is the phase voltages. Okay, for the line voltage, okay, we can derive the line voltage from the circuit. Okay, from the three phase circuit, in this case from the three phase source or star connected circuit. Okay, how to determine VRY given phase voltage? How to determine VRY? You can apply Kirchhoff voltage law for this looping. Okay, for this looping, for example, to determine VRY from this looping, we can write that VRY equal to VRN minus VYN, VRN minus VYN. Okay, given VRN, okay, we have a VYN. So by solving this mathematic equation, okay, we got that VRN minus VYN equal to square root 3 V angle 30 degree. V angle 30 degree. Okay, so what we can say that, okay, we have a reference phase voltage V angle 0, but the line voltage VRY equal to, the magnitude is, we need to times by square root 3. Okay, which is the line voltage is greater than phase voltage by square root 3 V. Okay, but the phase angle actually is 30 degree leads the phase voltage. So we can say that line voltage leads phase voltage by 30 degree. Okay, look at to VYB. Okay, V voltage between Y and B line. Okay, we can determine this voltage by applying the Kirchhoff voltage law for this loop. Okay, VBN, VYB, VYN. Okay, by solving this KVL, we can determine that VYB equal to VYN minus VBN. Okay, we have a VYN, we have a VBN. So by solving this mathematical equation, we got square root 3 V angle minus 90 degree. This is minus 90 degree. Okay, similarly to the VBR. Okay, by solving this loop, by applying KVL, we got VBR equal to VBN minus VRN equal to square root 3 V angle minus 210 degrees. So what we can see from this line voltage, we can see that for phase voltage VYN equal to V minus 120 degrees. But for the line voltage VYB equal to minus 90 degree. Okay, square root 3 V angle minus 90 degree. Okay, basically is leads 30%, which mean minus, okay, the magnitude is we need to times square root 3, but the phase angle we just plus 30 degree. Okay, minus 120 plus 30 degree equal to minus 90 degree. Similarly to VBR, phase B VBN equal to V angle 120 or V equal to minus 240 degree. So the line voltage equal to square root 3 V angle minus 210 degree. Okay, which mean that 240 minus 240 plus 30 degree equal to minus 210 degrees. Okay, for star connected source, we have a line current equal to phase current. Okay, we have a line current equal to phase current. So the relationship between phase voltages and line voltages can be analyzed using phasor diagram. Okay, based on the phase voltage, okay, this is the phasor form, in phasor form, and line voltage in phasor form, we can draw the phasor diagram. So we can see that this is the phase voltage VRN, VYN, and then this is a VBN, this is a phase voltage, and then this is the line voltage VRY, VYB, and VBR. So from this phasor diagram, we can see that the line voltage leads phase voltage by 30 degree. Okay, so what we can conclude from this analysis, we can say that phase voltage, okay, we can say that phase voltage, this is the phase voltage, lags line voltage by 30 degree, lags, okay, mengikut. Or in other words, we can say that line voltage leads phase voltage by 30 degree. Okay, leads phase voltage by 30 degree. And the magnitude of the line voltage equal to square root 3 of the V phase. The magnitude of the line voltage is equal to square root 3 V phase. We can say that the line voltage is greater than phase voltage. Okay, phase voltage. Okay, this relation actually is important for the wire connected system that you have to understand and you have to remember. The line voltage leads phase voltage by 30 degree, and then the magnitude of the line voltage equal to square root 3 V phase. And then you have to know how to draw the phasor diagram lah, based on the phasor form information that we have derived before. Okay, so next, what we can conclude from this analysis, we can say that star connected source, in the star connected source, the line voltage is square root 3 times greater than phase voltage, V phase. So we can write that VL equal to square root 3 V phase. Okay, so please take note that line voltage leads phase voltage by 30 degrees. Okay, number one. Number two, any line currents is same as the current in the corresponding phase. We can say that line current equal to phase current. Line current equal to the phase current for R, Y, and B. This is the characteristic of the Y connected system, okay, or Y connected source that we need to understand. Okay, look at to the example. Okay, let's say given the following star connected source. Okay, given to the following star connected source, we have a star connected source. For example, we have R, Y, and B. Okay, find line voltage VRY, VYB, and VBR. Okay, this is the phase voltage is given. Okay, VBN, VRN, VYN is given. Okay, then draw the phasor diagram. And the last one, number three, determine the phase sequence of this system. Okay, first of all, what you need to do, okay, in order to determine the line voltage, first you have to determine the phase voltage. Okay, phase voltage from the circuit, we can determine the phase voltage. For example, VBN equal to 100 angle 0 volt, VRN equal to 100 angle negative 120 volt, and VYN equal to 100 angle positive 120 volt. Okay, so first of all, we need to write the phase voltage in polar form. We need to write the phase voltage in polar form, VBN, VRN, and VYN. Okay, VYN, this is VYN. Okay, same, 100 angle minus 200, negative 240 degree, or we can write in 100 angle positive 120 degree volt. Okay, then we can determine the, okay, from the circuit we can determine the VBR, the potential difference, okay, the voltage between point B and R. Okay, you can apply the Kirchhoff voltage law, VBR equal to VBN plus V and R. Okay, VBN equal, so we can say that VBN VNR plus, so become minus VRN. Okay, this is a VBR, means this one is positive, this one is negative. Okay, so you solve this Kirchhoff voltage law, you can get VBR equal to, okay, VBN minus VRN. So your VBR equal to 100 173.2 angle 30 degree volt. Okay, so your VRY equal to 173.2 angle minus 90 degree. Why minus 90 degree? Because the phase difference between line voltage and phase voltage equal to 30 degree. Okay, so the magnitude of the line voltage actually is equal for all phases in balanced 3-phase system. The difference actually is the phase angle. So the phase angle, the different the voltage of the phase angle of the line voltage actually is leads the phase voltage by 30 degree. So negative 120 degree plus 30 degree. Okay, similarly to VYB, line voltage at the Y, okay, magnitude is same, the angle equal to plus 30 degree. Okay, this is the method one. So we have a alternative method to determine the line voltage from the given phase voltage. We know that in star connected source, the line voltage is square root 3 times greater than the phase voltage. We can say that VL equal to square root 3 V phase. The line voltage leads phase voltage by 30 degree. So we can simply write VBR, line voltage VBR equal to square root 3 times 100 angle, okay, square root 3 times 100 angle 0 plus 30 degree. Okay, this is the VBR. Okay, similarly to VRY, so the magnitude we need to times with square root 3 and angle we need to plus by 30. Okay, similarly to VYB. Okay, this one we need to times with square root 3. Yeah, we need to times with square root 3. Okay, square root 3. Okay, I forgot to write the square root 3 here. This is a square root 3. Okay, we write the square root 3. Okay, we use pen. Okay, sorry. This is a square root. Okay, this is a square root 3. Okay, we need to time with the square root 3 times 100 angle 120 plus 30 degree. Okay, so next you can use this approach lah. Okay, which is easy, and this is the simple approach lah. You just need to remember this characteristic for star connected system. Okay, so phasor diagram. Okay, from the phase voltage and then line voltages, you can draw the phasor diagrams. Okay, this is the phasor diagram for the phase voltage VBN, VRN, and VYN. Okay, this is the line voltage for VBR. Okay, this is a line voltage for VBR. How about VRY? VRY minus 90. Okay, this here need to write VRY. Okay, VRY. Okay, we try to write VRY. Okay, this is a VRY. Okay, VRY. And then VYB angle positive 150 degree. Okay, 150 degree here. Okay, this is a VYB. Okay, so how about the sequence either RYB or RBY. So you can see from the phasor diagram. Okay, R, okay, we can see from the phase voltage or line voltage. Let's say we see from the phase voltage RYB or RBY. So from here we can see that R followed by Y and then followed by B. So we call it RYB. So the phase sequence actually is R, Y, and B. Okay. This is the way how to determine the phase sequence. We can easily determine from the phasor diagram. We can easily determine from the phasor diagram. Okay. Let's see the example 3.3. Okay, let's see the example of 3.3. Okay, find phasor expression for all the phasors and line voltages of 415 volt. Okay, basically this is RMS voltage, 4-wire 3-phase supply. Okay, 4-wire 3-phase supplies, and then assume a RYB sequence. Okay, taking number one, phasor VRN as a reference. Okay, number two, consider phasor VRY as a reference, our reference. So the question is determine the phasor expression of all phase and line voltage. Okay, so in other words, we can say that find the phase voltage and line voltage. Okay, of a 415 volt 4-wire 3-phase supply. So I think first of all, you need to redraw the information from the question. Okay, we have a supply, 3-phase supply, 4-wire, R, Y, B, and neutral wire. 4 wires means you have a R, Y, and B. And then another wire, we have a neutral wire. 415 volt, this means, what's the meaning of 415 volt? Okay, this is the line voltage. This is the line voltage. Okay, so we can write, given the line voltage equal to 415 volt, therefore the phase voltage equal to V phase equal to V line divided by square root 3, because V line equal to square root 3 times V phase. Okay, in this case, given V line, so we can determine phase voltage equal to VL divided by square root 3. Okay, equal to 240 volt. This is the phase voltage. So number one, based on the question, taking VRN as a reference. Okay, so we can write for a symmetrical balance 4-wire star connected source, we write the VRN, this is the reference, 240 angle 0, VYN, RYB sequence. So RYB means VRN, VYN, 240 angle minus angle negative 120 degrees volt, and VBN equal to 240 angle minus 240 volt, or we can write 240 angle positive 120 degrees volt. Okay, so for RYB sequence, we know line voltage VRY leads VRN by 30 degree. Okay, so we can write for the line voltage VRY equal to, this is the magnitude of the line voltage, equal to square root 3 times 240. Square root 3 times 240 or 415 angle 30 degree. Leads mean 0 plus 30 degree. Okay, for the next phase, VYB equal to 415 volt angle minus 90 degree. Why minus 90 degree? Because minus or negative 120 degree plus 30 degree equal to negative 90 degree volt. Okay, similarly to VBY, 415 volt angle minus 210 volt. How to get to minus or negative 210 volt? you can get from the minus 240 volt plus 30, sorry, minus 240 degree plus 30 degree. So you will get minus 210 degrees. Okay, this is the line voltage. This is the line voltage. Okay, so from the phase voltage and line voltage, you can draw the phasor diagram. Okay, VRN as a reference. Okay, what is the meaning of reference? Means our phase angle equal to zero. Okay, phase angle equal to zero, VYN, VBN, and then you can write VRY. Okay, this is a VRY angle 30 degree. VRY angle 30 degree. Okay, angle 30 degree. Okay, how about VYB? Minus 90. Here, this is our VYB. Okay, VYB, sorry. Okay, and then VBY minus 210. 210 here, VYB. Okay, this is the phase diagram. Okay, the sequence is R, Y, and B. R followed by Y and then followed by B. So the sequence actually is RYB. RYB sequence. Okay? Can you follow me? Okay. Okay, question number two. Taking VRY as a reference. So we write VRY as a reference. VRY means line voltage. Okay, 415 angle 0. VYB 415 angle minus negative 120 degrees volt. VBR equal to 415 angle negative 240 degrees volt, or we can write 415 angle minus 120 degrees volt. Okay, this is our reference. This is the line voltage become our reference. So the next question, we need to determine the phase voltage. Okay, so for the Y connected load, we know that phase voltage lags line voltage by 30 degree. Okay, phase voltage lags line voltage by 30 degree. Okay, we remember that our line voltage leads phase voltage by 30 degree. So in other words, we can say that phase voltage lags line voltage by 30 degree. So what's the meaning of lags? You need to minus by 30 degrees. Okay, phase voltage, this is a amplitude of the phase voltage equal to line voltage divided by square root 3. Okay, VRN, VYN. Okay, this one minus 30 degree, so you will got minus negative 150 degrees. Okay, similarly to VBN, so the magnitude you need to divide it by square root 3, and then the angle you need to lex, you need to minus by 30 degree. So from the line voltage and phase voltage, you can draw the phasor diagram. You can draw the phasor diagram. VRY as a reference. This is our reference. Okay. Okay. So if you understand these two exercise, these two example, so you can try this exercise for Y connected system. Let's say in a symmetrical balanced RYB 3 phase star connected source, okay, given VRN equal to 240 angle minus 15 degree volt. Okay, so question number one, determine the phase voltages and line voltages. Okay, determine the phase voltages and line voltages, number one. Number two, draw the phasor diagram of line and phase voltages. Okay, then you need to draw the phasor diagram. Okay, assume our system actually is balanced and phase sequence equal to RYB. So calculate your phase voltages. Okay, VRN, VYN, VBN, and calculate the line voltages VRY, VBY, okay, VRY, VYB, and VBR. Okay, so you can try this exercise. If you can answer this exercise, which means that you understand this subtopic, inshallah. Okay, so I think we can stop here for today. So next we will discuss about delta connected source, how to analyze the voltage and current in delta connected source. Okay, so you can try this exercise, and then we discuss in the next lecture, inshallah. Okay, thank you very much. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.